Proverbs chapter 17, the Proverbs of Solomon. Better is a dry morsel with quiet than a house full of feasting with strife. A servant who deals wisely will rule over a son who acts shamefully, and will share the inheritance as one of the brothers. The crucible is for silver, and the furnace is for gold, and the Lord tests hearts. An evildoer listens to wicked lips, and a liar gives ear to a mischievous tongue. Whoever mocks the poor insults his maker. He who is glad at calamity will not go unpunished. Grandchildren are the crown of the aged, and the glory of children is their father's. Fine speech is not becoming to a fool, still less is false speech to a prince. A bribe is like a magic stone in the eyes of the one who gives it. Wherever he turns, he prospers. Whoever covers an offense seeks love, but he who repeats a matter separates close friends. A rebuke goes deeper into a man of understanding than 100 blows into a fool. An evil man seeks only rebellion, and a cruel messenger will be sent against him. Let a man meet a she-bear robbed of her cubs rather than a fool in his folly. If anyone returns evil for good, evil will not depart from his house. The beginning of strife is like letting out water, so quit before the quarrel breaks out. He who justifies the wicked and he who condemns the righteous are both alike an abomination to the Lord. Why should a fool have money in his hand to buy wisdom when he has no sense? A friend loves at all times, and a brother is born for adversity. One who lacks sense gives a pledge, and puts up security in the presence of his neighbor. Whoever loves transgression loves strife. He who makes his door high seeks destruction. A man of crooked heart does not discover good, and one with a dishonest tongue falls into calamity. He who sires a fool gets himself sorrow, and the father of a fool has no joy. A joyful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. The wicked accepts a bribe in secret to pervert the ways of justice. The discerning sets his face towards wisdom, but the eyes of a fool are on the ends of the earth. A foolish son is a grief to his father, and bitterness to her who bore him. To impose a fine on a righteous man is not good, nor to strike the noble for their uprightness. Whoever restrains his words has knowledge, and he who has a cool spirit is a man of understanding. Even a fool who keeps silent is considered wise. When he closes his lips, he is deemed intelligent.
Yeah. As followers of Jesus Christ, we are gathered to worship and confess our beliefs. We believe that the Bible, as originally written, was God-breathed, both verbally and in every part. It is the final authority of our faith and lifestyle. We believe in one God, the Creator of heaven and earth, that in the unity of the Godhead, there are three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We believe that the Lord Jesus Christ, God's Son, was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of a virgin. He lived a sinless life, died and rose from the dead, ascended bodily to heaven, and is coming again to rapture his saints and establish his kingdom. We believe that the Holy Spirit is a divine person, equal with the Father and the Son and of the same nature. We believe man was created by the direct act of God and not from a previously existing form of life. By voluntary transgression, he fell from his state of innocence. Consequently, all men are now sinners by nature and by choice. We believe salvation of sinners is divinely initiated, wholly of grace, and accomplished only through the mediatorial work of the Son of God. It is not of works or religion. We believe in the local church and the universal church, which is the body of Jesus Christ. We believe water baptism is the single immersion of a believer in water, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to show his identification with Christ in his death, burial, and resurrection. It can do nothing for his salvation. We believe that the Lord's Supper is the commemoration of his death until he comes. We believe in the bodily resurrection of the just and the unjust. Believers by faith in Christ will spend eternity in the presence of God, unbelievers in everlasting punishment. We believe that every believer should live for God and separated from the world, and by the aid of the Holy Spirit should walk in Christian love and holiness. We believe that Jesus Christ commands his church to make disciples of every nation. We believe that the greatest thing man can do for himself is to love God above all, and the greatest thing he can do for others is to show them how to love God above all.
Thank you. us, joining with us in this worship service. Salamat, Ged. It is another privilege for us to study God's Word and continually grow by the knowledge and grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Sa pagsugod naton, let us ask first God's wisdom and the leading of the Holy Spirit in our study of His Word. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You, Lord, for Your goodness to us. Lord, we ask, Lord, that make us worthy as we worship You, as we study Your Word. Forgive us for what we have done, Lord, that is not glorifying. Lord, we ask You, we pray that fill us with the Holy Spirit so that we will be able to listen carefully and understand the things that we will be hearing today, that we will be able to grow in Your knowledge and Your grace in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we will be able to share this and live this thing, Lord, in our lives. Thank You, Lord, for Your goodness. Keep Your presence, Lord, in our midst. We bring back all the glory to You in what You have done to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Last time, last Sunday, we have learned that as a Christian and a church in a mission, our best reaction to persecution is not revenge or curse, but a God-approved prayer from which the reason of prayer is God's sovereignty. Now, if we are faced with persecution, ang pinaka the best naton nga balos, ang aton nga reaction is that a God-approved prayer. And the reason for that prayer is God's sovereignty. The reminder in that prayer is God's prophecy. The request to perform that prayer, in that prayer, is a proclamation of the gospel of Christ. And the results of prayer is we being filled with the Holy Spirit. And we speak the word of God boldly to others. So, we are also reminded of this message that when we face persecutions, when faced with persecutions, react by praying, understanding God's sovereignty, for His words are not empty. Request to speak the gospel boldly, and the Spirit of God will fill us to declare the gospel to others confidently. Kung face kita sa persecution, wala na ta pinaka the best or God-glorifying reaction other than praying. Because in praying, we understand God's sovereignty and that His commands, His words, His promises are not empty. Request, no? We have to request to speak the gospel boldly because the Spirit of God, no, amo ang magapuno sa aton, and eventually, we will be able to declare confidently the gospel of Jesus Christ. So, we will continue. And last Thursday, nagatag ko sa inyo sang message, meditation for those nga naka-attend sa Thursday na itong prayer meeting. We learned, no, from the two verses or two texts ng ginitun anaton that God has revealed in the Old Testament or in the Bible the copy and the shadow of the heavenly things. No, what will happen in the heaven with God, with Jesus Christ? God has already given us the shadow or a copy here on earth. And we said, we concluded from what we have read and learned that Jesus came to die to give us confident access to the holiest place, which is in the presence of God. As Hebrews chapter 10, verse 19 to 20 says, we have confidence to enter the holy places with the blood of Jesus by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain that is through his flesh. And also, we have said that Jesus came to die to become for us the place where we meet God. Hindi lang kay siya ang aton nga confident nga palaagyan or access sa holiest place, to the place where God is there, the presence of God. But also, he becomes the place because he is God. In John chapter 2, verse 19 to 21, Jesus answered them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days, I will raise it up. The Jews then said, it has taken 46 years to build this temple, and will you raise it up in 3 days? But he was speaking about the temple of his body. If we would meet God in worship, there is only one place we must go. Kung gusto kita mag-worship sa Ginoo, sa atubangan sa Ginoo, wala na sang ibang pang place nga kantuan naton. Not the building, not the church building, not the temple in the Jerusalem, but only to Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ became the shadow or the copy of the heavenly place on earth. So on this text today, we will find at least a heavenly place on earth. Matunan natin ano ang heavenly place diri sa sininga kalibutan, because our earth, our world today is full of darkness sa nagakalatabo. Disasters, pandemic, rumors of wars, no? Damo lang nagakatabo sa atong palibot. But we have this heavenly place on earth, which is the church. Church is the heavenly place on earth. When, no, may harap pa na siya ng criteria. Because there are so many church, nga daw hindi kakambal nga simbahan ni Jesus Christ. Because nagailainaway sila, no? Nagabaisay sila sa mga butang nga hindi man kinanlan baisan. Nagailinaway sila. Nagalibakanay sila. So, the church is the heavenly place on earth when Jesus Christ is within. No? Makambal kita nga ang simbahan is a replica or a copy or a shadow of a heavenly place diri sa kalibutan kung si Jesus Christ ara sa sulod. So the early church, there is a Jerusalem revealed 4 characteristics of the church as the heavenly place on earth. Okay? When their church showed these characteristics despite persecutions. Ano ina? What are these 4 characteristics? The church is united. The church is unselfish. When the church is unleashed. And when the church is uplifting. or uplifting. So let us study these four characteristics of the early church and how can we apply this sa aton man nga simbahan. So the first characteristic of the church as the heavenly place on earth. The church is a heavenly place on earth when the church is united. Hambal sang verse 32. All believers were one in heart and mind. No one claimed that any of their possessions was their own, but they shared everything they had. So the early church or the early Christians nag-aoptanay gid. They are one in heart and mind, but silingon, isa sila nga ginabatsyag, isa sila nga paminsaron, isa sila nga ang ila mga wishes sa ila kabuhi, isa man ang ila ginahope pag ila nga dream. No, grabe, no? Amo na nga naga problema kita usually sa mga churches because lain-lain kita interest. Lain-lain interest sang mga persons inside the church. But the early church showed us this shadow of the heavenly place on earth. That the church is or should be united. Isa sa heart, in mind, in soul, in thoughts, in feelings, in wishes, in hopes, and in dreams. So, ang Ginoo gusto kita to have this kind of unity and harmony. Pero, sa tuntod lang, it's very difficult. It's difficult to achieve. Especially, kung upod mo ang iban nga tao. Why? Hambal pa gani ni Frederick the Great. Once there was a person called Frederick the Great, nambal niya, the more I get to know people, the more I love my dog. The more ko nga makilala niyang mga people around him, the more nga ginaplanggan niyang iya ido because hindi lovable ang mga people around us. So it is difficult, or people find difficult to be with others in one heart and in one mind. Good lie. And think about this question. Who is the person who love or you love most in this world? Sino gid ba lang ginaplangga mo? Bisap si Jesus Christ, ha? Si Jesus Christ nagkaman, magin ang Ginoo nagkaman. Nga wala ka na sang first love, kundi siya. Aside from Christ, sinong plangga ni mo diriya sa kalibutan? Diba, si sino? Imo nga wife. No? Kung married ka, imo nga wife. Just this example. I hope nga hindi ni ma-offend si Inday sa akong example. Ang question ko, do you get along with your wife? No, or husband ba na, on the other hand, all the time, na, di ba? Di ba, biskan, ano nyo ka planggaan, ay nga, di ba, hindi ka mo gidya mag-vibes in all the time. Yara gidya yan, ha, hindi ka mo mag-insindihan, ay. So, kung mag-amo na, how much more sa isa ka simbahan? No? Sa isa ka pagtililipon? And punta na mo naton ang setup sang first nga church, first nga Christians. Kag punta na mo naton ang characteristics sang mga tawo. Makambal ka gid nga it is very difficult nga mangin one heart sila, one mind sila in their journey of being a church, no? Kung tanawin natin, dirigan isa sa chapter 4, mayara na persecution. Sa chapter 6, actually nag-arise ang mga early problems ang isa ka church. Pero ang truth dire, yung ipakita sa aton sa dire sa chapter 4 is that ang early church, they get along with one another. Di makabaka, paano sila nag-get along with one another? Ang ato na ginabalaan dire, since the time of Pentecost, no? That because they have one mind of Christ, no? Ara ang mindset nila naka-focus kay Jesus Christ. Ang ila pagpalangga naka-focus kay Jesus Christ. Ara ang spirito ni Jesus Christ sila living within them. That is why Christians ought to get along better than anyone else. Wala man nga nagatinikal kita. But mostly, if those Christians ara lang gid sa kay Jesus Christ, tuod ang ila pag-follow kay Jesus Christ, they get along better or better than other people that are not in Christ. Because, syempre, kung hindi kita nag-get along with one another, we are not obeying the command of Christ. No? Anong command yaw? Love one another. Diba? Nambaldra sa John 13, 34-35, a new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, and ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if ye have loved one another. Disciple ka ni Jesus Christ, if you love other people, if you love one another. That is why the most heavenly place on earth ought to be the church, where that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is within. And that is why God wants His church to be united. Kung wala si Jesus Christ sa church, ang church damo, no? Hindi united, whatever nga butang damo palalisay. But if Christ is within, the church is united and we could experience a heavenly place on earth. Ikaduwa, the church is a heavenly place on earth when the church is unselfish. Diba? Humble some verse 32b. No one claimed that any of their possession was their own, but they shared everything they had. Ang Ginoo gusto lang gid nga ang iyang mga katawhan mangin unselfish. Hindi dalok, no? Hindi dalok sa paghatag kun whatever man na siya ang gina-desire sa Ginoo. Kag nakita na naton sa next pagin nga truth. This is on verses 34-35. And that there were no needy persons among them, for from them to them, those who owned land or houses sold them, brought the money from the sales, and put it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to anyone who had need. No, kung isa kita kasimbahan, kabay pa, wala to sang aton nga membro na nagapakilim mo sa dalan. Wala ta sang membro nga kagutuman, because we are sharing our possessions with others. Punta na wun naton ini nga church, wala ni sila nag implement sang ano ha, ultimatum or whatever nga martial law para lang makahatag. Wala ginang balanda o ang hindi makahatag, hindi na nabilong sa sininga organization or simbahan. Because there are churches nga kung hindi kaya kahatag ng pagwaon kanila, hindi ka na membro, kaya huwag kagatag. Diriya, sa first church, wala diya sang pwersahan. It is on their heart because they are one in heart and one in mind. So in naghatag sila on their own love. Actually ini mga churches no nagdamo pagid ang gina-contribute nila. Pero ang isa diri ka natingalahan naton is that they are in the midst of persecution. Di ba? Gin-persecute si Peter kag John. Pagpuli nila, nag-pray sila. Tapos nila pray. No? Ano nila ginimo? Amo ni? No? They are one in mind and heart. Kag nag-share sila sa ilang posisyon. And on top of that, no, ang persecution, hindi lang one time. Actually, sa sunod pagid ng mga tinion, persecute pagid sila. Kag even before si Jesus Christ ginlansang sa cross, nanghambal na si Jesus Christ sa ila. So may warning niya si Jesus Christ nga they will be persecuted. Aw. Ang basa ng John, chapter 9, verse 22. Ang mga Jewish rulers nag-agree na daan that if anyone confessed that Jesus was Christ, he would put out of the synagogue. So anyone kuno nga mag-witness nga si Jesus Christ, Messiah or Christ, or si Jesus, si Christ, i-excommunicate nila sa synagogue. So, hindi nila papasudlon, wala access, wala tanan. No? So, even si John Hill, no? Si John Hill, isa ka person nga nag-explain or nagatag commentary about this, kung maghambal ka kung gin put out ikaw sa synagogue, do parios lang na nga pati ang imong resources kwaon. This is just the view or commentary of John Hill. Kag wala kagid sang business sa synagogue do persona nan grata ikaw. Ti grabe ina kabudlay no para sa mga Jewish people. So sa sina ang principle diri nga ginatudlo sa ila in this time no that when Jesus Christ leads the church is within the church, people within the church give anything or resources generously to help others in need, as what we have in Galatians chapter 6 verse 10. So then, while we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, and especially to those who are of the household of faith. No, if may ara man lang ta sang kasarang, or may ara kita oportunidad, we will do good to all people. Kagin emphasize pagide ni Paul, especially to those who are of the household of faith. But sila ang fellow nato ni believers. I hope sa Masaba Christian Church Talisay 2, tagsa-tagsa kita may mga God-given nga mga resources or talents or capabilities. I hope nga kung may opportunity man lang kita, buligan nato ng iban. In many ways, nga pwede nato mabulig. It's either sa magpadlagan sa negosyo, tidamo ta di mga businessman sa aton. Doon hindi man gidagko ang business, pero may business. May mga teachers ta diri. May mga ano pagida, may possibly may mga panday ta diri nga sa God. So, you have that opportunity to share your resources, to do good to all people, but not to take advantage. Kag ini i-share naton especially to those who are the household of faith, aton fellow members of believers. So God wants us to be generous, no? Giving our time, our talents, our tithes, no? And offerings for the glory of God. And if we are growing spiritually, kung gagrow kita spiritually, we will care for the need of others, most especially to the household of faith. Hambal ni Melvin Newland, if you are grumbling, kung gahumod ikaw and complaining, if you're not joyful in the Lord, it is probably a strong indication that you are not growing in the Lord. Na kung gakumod-kumod ka kuno, kag nagasagi ka complain, reklamo, kag hindi ka happy, upod sa mga fellow members sa church, very strong gina nga indication that you are not growing in the Lord. Bumasubo sina. Masubo na kung kita ng gasu, sige lang kumod, no? Kung may mga bululigan, may mga kinanlan naton i-assist ng mga may need. Dason makumod kaya? Kag mga reklamo, ikaw? Kaya ito yung may need, no? Gintagaan siya. Ikaw ya? Tiki kasarang ka man. Wala kayo gintagaan. Kaya may kasarang ka man. No? Ti, makumod kaya? No, that's hindi kaya joyful sa Ginoo. So, strong indicator na siya nga wala ka gagrow sa Ginoo because ang imo yung interest ang imo gina gusto matabok. On the other hand, atong mga Christians kinagagrow sa kaya Ginoo, excited sila yung magbulig. No? Kabalo ka kay si Jesus Christ nang imo Diyos kid ka manluluwas kag mag-aabot siya. Di excited ka nga magahulat sa iya. While you are excited, you're also doing kung ano ang iyaging command, no? Sa pag-share sa iya nga pulong, sa pag-share sang resources mo sa iban nga nagkinanlan. And that is ang growth nimo. Kung ginapalangga mong iban because nabalaan mo nga plangga ka sa Ginoo. So, the growing Christians says, kung gitagaan siya sa assignment, tagaan siya sa task, or kinanlan nga himuon, bulig sa church, willing siya yung magbulig. Wala na siya yung naga-question, wala siya naga-kumod. And whenever nga need maghatag sa offering ti isubong way man taga collect offering, even nga ni way taga collect sa tithe, which is ang Ginoo ga expect gid nga mahatag kita sa aton tithe. So ti ato na lang nga inner man nga pag recognize sa goodness ang Ginoo sa aton, may separate kita sa aton tithe kag ihatag naton dira. Kun indi ta man mahatag directly sa kay BJ, masupot na dira sa aton nga if need sang church or kung magbalik na kita sa pagtililipon, dira naton mahatag sa Ginoo ang aton nga offering kag tithes. Kag kung may bululigan, makakwa lang kita kag mahatag naton sa mga in need. So, sa imo pag-share, sa imo paghatag, you are happy. Ang feeling ni mo, happy ikaw, ga-enjoy ikaw. And that is, makahambal kita. The church is a heavenly place on earth because everyone shares and gives their possession to others. Ikatatlo, the church is a heavenly place on earth when the church is unleashed. What's it on? Gin free, no? Gin pagwa. Hamba sa verse 33, when with great power the apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And God's grace was so powerfully at work in them all. ang early church, after some persecution to kay Peter kag John, wala sila yung naging higtan sila kag nagpahimunong sila sa ilang balay. So after 2 years ng persecution, despite persecution, they are unleashed. Nagwa sila ya, nag-share sila sa iban. Wala sila ya na kulbaan. No? So gusto nila yung mag-share sa pulong sa Ginoo. So ang Ginoo, gusto kita nga i-unleash, no? As a church. This means He wants us to be bold on our witness for His gospel. So ambal na dira, we need to be bold like the apostles. Na in verse 33, with great power the apostles gave witness to the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Na wala sila na kulbaan, nag-go out sila. Remember, sa opposition to sa early church, may ara na. Ginpriso na gani sila ni Peter kag ni John. Ginwarningan na sila nga hindi sila maghambal party kay Jesus. So ang gospel, even today, will face opposition. Okay? Pero, hambal sa Matthew chapter 16, verse 18, Jesus said, "And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it." Biskan ano pa na ang maabot, mahambalya kay Peter, wala sang may makapirdi, wala sang may mahinder sa pag-share sa akon pulong. So all forces mana, human forces or evil forces, cannot stop the spread of the gospel. So ang aton lang gid gusto sang Ginoo maging bold kita sa pag-witness naton kay Christ. Kag with that, ang apostles, God's grace was so powerfully at work in them. So ang grace ng Ginoo powerfully, there is a power working on the gospel, and it is the power of God. So just like sa ginhambal ni Paul sa Romans chapter 1:16, the same power man nga ang pon nila ni Peter kag ni John kag sa mga first Christians. Hambalya, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to salvation for everyone who believes, for the Jew first and also for the Greek. So ang encouragement sa aton MCC Talisay 2, we have the same power, which is the power of God into salvation of everyone. So nothing can change the world. Wala na sang iban pa nga maka damo sa mga libro nga nasulat nga amuning maka-change sa aton kabuhi. Amuni ang maka-change sa kalibutan para mag-nami ang kalibutan natin, para mangin heavenly-like, heavenly place on earth. There is nothing that can change the world like having Christ, like having the salvation of Christ in us and living Jesus Christ in our lives. No? I think si everyone nakabati na sang Heinz nga ketchup, no? familiar ka muna? I forgot kung ano na siya nga do ano bala mo? Pizza Hut do gamit sa sang Heinz nga ketchup, hindi lang po sure. Ah. Pero ang Heinz nga ketchup ang tagiyasin na si Mr. Henry John Heinz. Pero kabalo ka mo nga si Henry John Heinz was a devoted Christian. No? So, one day, sa ilang nga church niya service, ang speaker, no, kapamatigid si Henry Heinz sang wali, ang nagawali, nagtulok sa iya, tag nagpamangkot, "You are a believer, but with all your energy, why aren't you up and at it for the Lord?" Nya, believer ikaw. I don't know kung gintudlo gini nga siyagi directly or possibly may point na gusto lang iambal ang ini nga speaker, kag siya lang ang ginpoint, no? But not necessarily siya lang, pero para ni Satanan. Pero para sa iya, daw siya ang ginambalan. Ambalan siya nga, "Ti, believer ikaw, nga sa imo kusog, nga ara sa imo, ti nga wala man ka naga panglabot sa iban, wala ka man nag-share sa iban, parte kay Jesus, even mag-mention lang yung gani isang kaayos ang Jesus, ni Jesus sa imo." No, ti, sina nga adlaw sang nabati anak ni Heinz kaga sa iya gigin direkta ang question na ganun siya do. Nag-akig siya, uli siya, akig siya. Kaga ina nga gabi, hindi siya katulog. Kaga since hindi siya katulog, hasta na sa kagahon, nangamuyo siya. He prayed to God nga Ginoo nang doon na igo to sang message, no? Nga buligan siya nga ilid ang mga tao pagi sa iya kabuhi, no? Sa kay Jesus nga ila personal Lord and Savior. So after or a day after, nagkadto sa isa ka meeting with the bank presidents, mga bank presidents, kagti tigatulo para ida sila. Kaga pag sa ang iya tupad ginambalan niya sang iya joy nga na experience of knowing Jesus. No? Amula na, possibly nambal niya nag-share sila siguro sang ila kabuhi, kag nakambal siya, mention siya nga kabalo ka ng akon kabuhi, happy ko because may Jesus Christ ko. Si Jesus Christ akong Savior. Amula ginagawa siguro ako simple, no? Kag ang iya nga friend nga bank president, na-surprise siya. Kagambal, kabalo ko nga Christian ka, pero na-wonder ako nga many times, wala kagid naka-speak sa akon about sina, about salvation, nga ra kay Jesus Christ. Kag sugod sina nga adlaw, ang ina nga tao nga ginmunuhan niya, party sang goodness ang Ginoo sa iya, ang salvation ni Jesus Christ sa iya, yung naghatag siyang joy sa iya. This man became the first out of 267 ka mga tao nga gin-sharean ni Henry Heinz nga nadala niya kay Jesus Christ. So, sa aton nga pag-istorya, sa aton nga party sa life ni Henry Heinz, no, possibly, this is the way si Henry nga gin-share niya, amuning platform niya, no? Nag-share lang siya. Amuning opportunity niya to share the gospel. For Peter and John, sa Acts chapter 3 and 4, ang platform nila ya is, anong plagyan nila? Atong lame man nga ginayo nila. No? Kag damo ang nakakita, damo tao nagpalapit, kag that's the time, gin-share nila ang gospel. Even si Paul, sa Acts chapter 19, verse 8 to 10, he went into synagogue and spoke boldly for 3 months, reasoning and persuading concerning the things of the kingdom of God. But when some were hardened and did not believe, but spoke evil of the way, before the multitude, he departed from them and withdrew the disciples, reasoning daily in the school of Tyrannus. So, dire, gin ano siya, wala siya gin sa pack, nagtig-up, ganing ulo sa mga tao sa iya pagpanugit, parte kay Jesus. Pero wala siya nag-back out, no? Nag-back out sa sinay mga tao, pero nangita sa way, makashare sa iban in the school of Tyrannus. Verse 10, and this continued for 2 years, so that all who dwelt in Asia heard the word of the Lord Jesus, both Jews and Greeks. So, damo siya na sharean dito sa school of Tyrannus. So, wala siya. Possibly, ang platform yan nila ni Paul, no? Ni Peter, ni John, medyo difficult yung mga sitwasyon. Possibly sa imo, kasi may mga ordinary lang yung mga platforms, no? Ara kada sa upod mo sa imo pusina, kagduwa na lang ka mo. Kag nag-istorya sa mga, ano niya, mga kabudlayan niya sa kabuhi. Dasa nagsulod sa ulo mo, amo na diglong time na ma-share ko pa Jesus, ay. Dalangid daw, mangita ko na isang spark. Mahulat ka pa sang spark nga amo na gid na ang sign. Ti amo na na sang sign sa pagmunoy plang daan nga may mga kabudlayan sa kabuhi. Amo na nang sign, i-share mo na sa Jesus Christ. We have so many platforms, no? Possibly not the same with Peter and John, not the same with Paul, pero kita, we have that same platform. So, ang pamangkot, tira, how long has it been since you told someone what God has done in your life? Basi sang ano ka pa, sang 8 years ago pa, inanugid ka parte kay Jesus sa iban? Or maybe, hindi mo ma-experience si Jesus because ikaw, nadaan, wala man ka naga-lakat. Wala man ka fully committed kay Jesus sa Ginoo. That's why hindi ka man gani ka-share sa iban. How long has it been since you shared someone about Christ? His salvation for all. No? This is a challenge for us. No? As a church, saan o kita bala ng share kay Jesus? No? Basi, gatipon lang kita diri, pero each one of us has not been with this opportunity to share sa ngalan ni Jesus Christ, ang salvation ni Jesus Christ sa iba. No? I hope na all of us, hindi lang isa or dua or tatlo, all of us will be encouraged to share because with this, we could see the heavenly place on earth through our church being unleashed to share the gospel of Christ. Hambal sa verse 3, with great power, the apostles continued to testify the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And the result is that God's grace was so powerfully at work in them all. Hambal pagani ni Dr. John Hill, a Baptist pastor, 250 years ago, great grace was upon them all. Hindi lang kay Peter, hindi lang kay John, kundi sa bilog nga church. Great grace was upon them all. So ano na siyang meaning sa atin as a church? One thing it means is this, God will give us everything we need to do. To do everything. Ang Ginoo, magahatagid sang bugay niya powerfully sa aton, even sa tanan aton nga kinanlanon, para sa iya kay mayaan. Kung ano ang iya gusto matabo sa aton, ang will niya sa aton kabuhi, hindi niya tapupabayan, i-provide niya gid kita sang bugay niya all the time. Hambal sa Romans chapter 8, verse 31 to 32. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us things? Tinatagaganing iyang abugtong anak. Why not all the things we need? in order to proclaim Him, in order to glorify Him. God will give us everything that we need for His glory. No? Amutab lang, ikot ko lang sinong Errol. Balya, kung kapangayo, kay aeroplano, no? Siyempre, hindi na iapaghatag sa Ginoo ang aeroplano para lang sa imo lang personal. Pero kung mag-request ikaw, even lang sa simple things or helicopter pa da ang request mo because kay gusto ni sa Ginoo i-glorify ang ngalan niya. Ihatag na sa Ginoo. God wants His church to be unleashed. That means bold in our witness and blessed in our work for Him. So He wants His church to be unleashed. Nga man, for great grace is upon those who obey His will. Ang fourth nga point here is the church is a heavenly place on earth when the church is uplifting. Sa verse 36 to 37, nag-mention din rin sa isa ka extraordinary nga example of sharing. No? Joseph, a Levite from Cyprus, whom the apostles called Barnabas, which means son of encouragement, sold a field he owned and brought the money and put it at the apostles' feet. Ano ginimo ni Barnabas? No? Kung tanawin ni mo, ang ngalan niya pala, si Barnabas, ang meaning, son of encouragement. So, si Barnabas is well known as an encourager. So, sa ako niya mga pag-tanaw, based on my experience, si Barnabas possibly, since he is a person of encouragement, ginhimo niya ni ang pagbaligya sa iyang field, which is already extreme, no? Sino man bisa aton bisubong mabaligya sa aton nga balay, mabaligya sa aton bilog yun nga property, dasan niya tagta to sa church, possibly guro, mambak mo, sobra na gina iya, no? Pero yun si Joseph, or si Barnabas, ginbigyan niya yung field. Kung mga baka field, hindi lang ni 100 square meters, dako ni siya nga field. He was able to do extremely generous act, maybe just to encourage other followers, believers, to do the same. No? Paris pala sa atin, ha? Oh, sige, share kita. Di wala may may share. Okay, ari ako no, ah. 3,000 ah. No? Di, ang iban mo, yan na lang eh. Di, siyempre, hindi man sila katagani 3,000, di, matag sila shin. 500, 200, no? Because di ikaw gani, nga, hindi mangin ka muna ka mangranon, di, naghatag kaya sa 3,000. Di, ang iban mo, huya na. So, na-encourage sila sa imo. No? Possibly si Barnabas, sa mga ni, oh, sige, ako na, isa ka field. Grabe, no? Isa ka field, no? Worth ni pila ka million, siguro ning iya. Ting iban, siyempre na-encourage man, ti sige, mahatag man kami, amuning amon ni hatag. So, we need, in this world, no? We are troubled, actually. And when we are troubled, siyempre, kung isado ka, kabugat. And even sa pag-share na lang naton sa aton church, kabugat, because kita gani, nagkakabudlay kita, ma-share pa ta sa iban, no? But we need people nga maka-encourage sa iban. We need people in our church that could give encouragement to others, also to share, also to encourage others in their difficulties. Hambag yung isang Hebrews chapter 10, verse 24 to 25. And let us consider how we may spur one another toward love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together as some are in a habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. So ang church as is a heavenly place on earth when each member of the church is in a habit of encouraging one another. Kami sa mga MCC Talisay volunteers, no? Sila ni Joy Joy, ni Bijay, ako, sinang Chiche, no? Sila ni Inday, Nunoy. Mayroon kami task of pamustahanay, no? Kamustahanay sa atin mga fellow members. Kaga possibly encouragement in words and in the word of God. I hope nga kamo man, no? Take time kamo, i-reach out aton mga fellow believers, fellow relatives or fellow friends nga nag-join man sa aton sa pagpanimbahon sa una. I-reach out man sila, no? Pakamustaha sila. Encourage sila sa pulong sa Ginoo nga mag-continue sila, mag-upod man sila, mag-join sila. Sila sa aton sa worship online kag pag worship man sa prayer meeting every Thursday. So because the most heavenly place on earth is our church when Jesus Christ is within. No? As no, the most heavenly place on earth ought to be the church of the Lord Jesus Christ, if Jesus Christ is within that church. And as a church, may God help us to be united, unselfish, unleashed, uplifting. No? Kabay pa, ang MCC Talisay 2 hindi magpabilin nga ano lang, PPP, pungko, pamati, pauli. No? I hope that each one of us will be united in our hearts and in our minds. We will be sharing our resources together so that there will be no needy person sa aton nga church. We will be unleashed to proclaim the gospel of Christ to other people. Wala lang naga-contain lang gid kita sa aton nga respective corner sa aton balay or sa aton church. Uplifting, we are encourager to others. We encourage others to continue to depend on Christ, to live in Christ, and to trust in God, in Jesus Christ. No? Salamat, Gid. And lastly, we will be reminded of this from what we have learned in this text. A church that lives Christ within, 100%, no? Kung si Jesus Christ ara sa aton, can experience heavenly place even on earth. By being united in mind and heart, unselfish in possessions, unleashed for the proclamation of the gospel of Christ, and uplifting to one another. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, salamat gid sa sining very encouraging words. Nga hindi na kami maghulat, Ginoo, sang langit, because you have already showed to us the shadow, the copy of heaven here on earth. And that is your church. And we could be a church, a heavenly place on earth, if Christ is within us. Lord, kabay pa united kami. We are unselfish. We are unleashed to proclaim your gospel. And we are uplifting to one another. Lord, nabalik naman ang pagdayo, pagpasalamat sa amon nga natun-an subong, sa imo pag-lead sa amon. In Jesus' name, Amen.